City of Greenville has higher standards, both state and federal standards that folks have to meet when they develop in our city. So we're here in Cleveland Park, right off McDaniel. There's a big bend in the Reedy River, and we have a rock structure in the middle of the stream. This is a cross vein. What it helps do is helps control that erosive velocity of the river before it hits this river bend. We've created a pool, which is great habitat. I can see fish swimming around right now. But we also, on either sides, have removed invasive species and planted native materials. We've gotten a lot of comments about how this place needs a haircut. It needs a trim. But I'm very happy with it. What I look at when I see this is young trees and young successive plants that are ultimately going to form a natural river corridor here on this bend of the river right by McDaniel. So I'm very, very excited to see how this succession is going to play out through the next few years. We're a big proponent of natural systems, green infrastructure. So you'll see when the city of Greenville does a project that we incorporate natural systems to demonstrate that it's effective at both armoring the stream bank and removing pollutants. The city of Greenville is part of the CRS program, community rating system. We're actually rated as a 5, which is the best rating in the entire upstate. And what that does is it's a program that evaluates our floodplain management program and policies. Right where we're standing right now is a really good example of floodplain benching. And whenever we can get the room to do something like that, we definitely gather all that we can. Whenever urban development encroaches into a watershed, you're going to have that stream corridor more intense. And if you can figure out a way to relieve some of that volume when it does flow, what you're going to have is a lot of energy dissipation, and you're going to provide that river a place to release without flying downstream with high velocity. What you see here, if you're looking on the left bank, that bend, if you remember, used to be much taller, and we cut it down significantly all the way close to the road. So that, imagine all that volume of fill that was there to begin with has been removed in order for flood events to release that river's energy out there. And so what happens is the river eventually settles into that elevation that makes sense for the river. So moving forward, obviously we've made good gains, but there's a lot more to do. And we're studying a lot of different ways of improving our system, improving our processes. But think about where we've come from. Think about from 1972 and the Clean Water Act and how things have changed. I think that we've come a tremendous amount. I usually take an opportunity to remind folks how much better the Reedy River is today because of a lot of efforts from the Clean Water Act on down to local efforts.